are certainly some barriers we have to get instructors past to make peer instruction effective in their classroom. It's pretty typical to hear about the cost of the clickers and also about a little bit of apprehension about the technology. Another thing I have to learn in order to be able to teach my class. Those are pretty easy to solve. The biggest barrier, though, that I hear frequently is instructors who say, there's no way you can take my content, my expertise, and turn it into multiple choice questions. You just can't use multiple choice in my kind of a class. When instructors talk about not being able to find multiple choice questions that can test their material, I think they're thinking about a multiple choice exam. Can I reduce my content to a bunch of simple questions that students can answer A, B, C, D, E? And it's true that most fields cannot be reduced simply like that. So instead, what we're trying to convince these instructors of is don't test content with peer instruction. Create a question that makes the students think and behave like experts. Think of the question as the beginning of four or five conversations you want your students to have. And it's not that there's necessarily even a right answer. It's that these are the things that experts in the field do. They talk like this, they think like this, they discuss like this. That's the right kind of question to ask for peer instruction. And when we convince instructors that such a thing does exist, they're more on board. Another way to overcome that barrier is to find good peer instruction questions in the instructor's discipline. A historian is not interested in how to ask a good physics question, and vice versa. So if I can find questions in economics for the economists, and in literature for the English majors, and in physics for the physicists, and in bio for the biologist, and show them this is what it could look like in your classroom, we get a lot better buy-in from the instructors.